Hi students, today we are discussing about the topic is morphology of flowering plants and the class number is 6. Morphology means it is a branch of botany. Morphology is a branch of botany. It deals with the study of study and description of plant organs like root, stem, leaf, flower, fruit, seed, etc. is called as morphology. The morphology is a branch of botany. It deals with the study and description of plant organs. The plant organs like are plant parts like root, stem, leaf, flower, fruit, seed, etc. If you pull a weed plant, any weed plant, we can observe the parts like root, stem, leaves. These are the vegetative parts. Plant contain root, stem and leaves. These are the vegetative parts of the plant, and it also contain flowers and fruit seeds. Flower is the reproductive part of the plant, and the root, stem and leaves are the vegetative parts of the plant. And the roots grown in positive geotropic manner, positive geotropism, and stems grown in positive phototropic manner, positive phototropism. First, we are discussing about root. It is the underground part of the plant. The root is the underground part. It is present in the soil. Hence, it is the underground part of the plant, and it develops from the radical of the germinating seed of embryo. Root is the underground part of the plant, and it develops from the radical of the germinating seed of an embryo. At the time of seed germination, during the favorable condition, the seed obtain water from soil and oxygen from the atmosphere, and the seed can germinate and produces two structures. First one is radical and second one is plumule. Radical grow into the soil and they develop into root system, and the plumule grow above the soil and they develop into shoot system or stem. Hence, root is the underground part of the plant, and it develops from the radical of the germinating seed of the embryo. Next, root systems. Root systems are three types. First one is tap root system. Second one is fibrous root system. And third one is adventitious root system. Root systems are three types. First one is tap root system. Tap root system means in some plants like dicots. Dicots means the seed with two cotyledons. Example, pea, beans, groundnut. These are the dicotyledonous plants. In dicots, this is the dicot seed. The seed germinate and produces radicle and plumule. The radicle grow into the soil and they develops into primary root or tap root. Primary root or tap root. Radicle grow into the soil and they develops into primary root or tap root. The primary root produces secondary roots or lateral roots. Next, the secondary roots produces third type of roots. These are tertiary roots. The third type of roots are called tertiary roots. Primary root constitute with its secondary root and tertiary roots together is known as tap root system, and it is present in the dicot plants. Next, second one is fibrous root system in monocots. Example, rice, maize, wheat, sorghum, sugarcane. These are the monocot plants. In monocots, the radicle is short-lived at the time of seed germination. The radicle is short-lived. After the disintegration of radicle, many roots develops from the lower side of the stem. These roots are called fibrous roots, and the root system is called fibrous root system, and it is present in the monocot plants. Next, third type of root system is adventitious root system. In banyan tree, Ficus bengalensis, in banyan tree and monstera, radicle roots develops other than the radicle. Hence the root system is called adventitious root system. Examples, banyan tree, monstera, these are the examples of adventitious root system. Generally, the roots are achlorophyllous, absence of chlorophyll pigments, they are brown in color and they do not consist of nodes and internodes. Next, functions of the root. They gives anchorage to the plant, and by the presence of roots, they involve absorption of water and minerals. From the soil. These are the main functions of the root. They gives anchorage or support to the plant, and second one is they involves the absorption of water and minerals from the soil. These are the normal functions of the root. And now I am discussing about the root modifications. Root modification means the changes that occurs in the a permanent change that occurs in the shape and structure of the root and modified to perform special functions related to the environment is called as root modifications. A permanent change that occurs in the shape and structure. Modified to perform other functions related to environment. Is now called as root modifications. The root modifications are 8 types. First one is storage roots or tuberous roots. Storage roots are tuberous roots. Roots store food material and become swollen. Hence, the roots are called storage roots. Due to the storage of food material in the roots become tuberous. Hence, they are also called as tuberous roots. The roots store food material and become swollen. Hence, the roots are called storage roots. Due to storage of food material, the roots become tuberous. Hence, they are also called as tuberous roots. Example, in carrot and turnip. Turnip means beetroot. In carrot and turnip, tap roots store food material. Tap roots store food material in carrot and turnip. Next, and in sweet potato, adventitious roots store food material. Adventitious roots store food material in sweet potato. Next, fibrous roots store food material in asparagus. And in asparagus, fibrous roots store food material. Due to storage of food material, the roots become swollen. Hence, the roots are called as tuberous roots. And the diagram of carrot. The shape of the carrot is conical in shape and top shaped in beetroot. Next, and in asparagus, fibrous roots. Fasciculated tuberous roots are found in asparagus. Fasciculated tuberous roots. This is the first type of root modification, storage roots. Second one, prop roots are pillar roots. Prop roots are pillar roots. In banyan tree, the roots are large and heavy. They hang in air for some time and the roots develops from the lower side of the branches. Roots develops from the lower side of the branches, and these roots are large and heavy. Hence, they are hang in air for some time and grow into the soil, and they give mechanical support to the branches. These type of roots are called as prop roots, and these roots appear like a pillar like structure. Hence, the roots are also called as pillar roots. Example, banyan tree. These are the prop roots or pillar roots. Next, third type of roots are stilt roots. Example, maize and sugar cane. In maize and sugar cane, roots develops from the lower nodes of the stem. Roots develops from the lower nodes of the stem and grow into the soil, and they give mechanical support to the stems. Such type of roots are called as stilt roots. This is the lower node of the stem. The lower node of the stem produces a supporting roots. These supporting roots develops from the lower nodes of the stem and grow into the soil, and they give mechanical support to the stems. These roots are called as stilt roots. Next, fourth type of roots are velamen roots or epiphytic roots. Some plants which grow on another plants, such type of plants are called epiphytes. These epiphytic plants have specialized roots. Epiphytes have specialized roots. These specialized roots absorb moisture from the atmosphere. Due to the presence of a dead hygroscopic tissue called velamen tissue, due to the presence of velamen tissue, these tissue absorb moisture from the atmosphere. Hence, these roots are also called as velamen roots or epiphytic roots. Example, wanda. Wanda plant consists of two types of roots. First one is climbing roots. These are the small branched roots. These roots attach to the substratum. Next, another type of roots are large and branched. These large and branched roots are called as velamen roots. These roots absorb moisture from the atmosphere. Hence, they are also called as velamen roots or epiphytic roots. Next, fifth type of roots are respiratory roots. Plants which grow in swampy areas. The plants which grow in swampy areas are oxygen lagged areas. Lagged means absence of oxygen. Plants which grown in swampy areas are oxygen lagged areas. The roots produces some aerial branches. The roots produces aerial branches. These branches grow upward. These branches grow upward direction and have pneumatophores. These roots have pneumatophores. Due to the presence of pneumatophores, they uptake oxygen from atmosphere and involves the respiration process. Hence, the roots are called as respiratory roots. Example, mangrove plants like Rhizophora and Avicennia. These roots are called respiratory roots. Plants which grown in swampy areas or oxygen lagged areas, the roots produces some aerial branches. These branches have small pores called pneumatophores. Due to the presence of pneumatophores, roots uptake oxygen from atmosphere and involves in respiration. Hence, the roots are called respiratory roots. Examples, Rhizophora and Avicennia jessica also. These are the pneumatophores. Due to the presence of pneumatophores, they uptake oxygen from atmosphere and involves in the respiration process. Hence, the roots are called as respiratory roots. Next, sixth type of roots, photosynthetic roots. In Tineophyllum, plant name is Teneophyllum. In Teneophyllum, stem and leaves are absent. Stem and leaves are absent. Only the plant have roots. The roots are chlorophyllous or green in color. Roots are chlorophyllous. Due to the presence of chlorophyll pigments, they are green in color and perform the photosynthesis. Hence, the roots are called photosynthetic roots. Generally, leaves perform photosynthesis, but in Teneophyllum, stems and leaves are absent. Absence of stems and leaves, the roots are green in color and perform the photosynthesis. Hence, the roots are called photosynthetic roots. These are the sixth type of roots, photosynthetic roots. Seventh type of roots are nodular roots. In members of Fabaceae, members of Fabaceae are leguminaceae. The roots have nodules. Roots has nodules, hence the roots are called as nodular roots due to the presence of nodules on the roots. Hence the roots are called nodular roots. In the root nodules, a nitrogen fixing symbiotic bacteria, the bacterium is called rhizobium bacteria. Rhizobium bacteria is a symbiotic bacteria. These bacteria symbiotic association with the roots of legume plants. Example, and involves the nitrogen fixation. These bacteria absorbs the atmospheric nitrogen. These bacteria absorbs atmospheric nitrogen and converts into ammonia, NH4+. Example, groundnut. Such type of roots are called as nodular roots. These are the root nodules. In members of Fabaceae, the roots have nodules, hence the roots are called nodular roots. In the root nodules, a nitrogen fixing symbiotic rhizobium bacterium is present. These bacteria absorbs the atmospheric nitrogen and converts into ammonia. Example, groundnut. Next, last type of roots are parasitic roots. Some plants depend on food for another plants. Such type of plants are called as parasites. These parasitic plants have specialized roots called haustorian roots. These parasitic plants have specialized roots called haustorian roots. These haustorian roots penetrate into the host xylem and phloem, host plant, xylem and phloem, and involves the uptake of water, minerals and food material from the host organism. Depending upon the uptake of water, minerals and food material, the parasites are divided into two types. First one is partial parasites and second one is complete parasites. Partial parasite means haustorian roots penetrate into the only xylem of the host and involves the uptake of water and minerals. They uptake only water and minerals from the host. Hence, the parasites are called partial parasites. Next, complete parasites means hostorial roots penetrate into both xylem and phloem and involves the uptake of water, minerals and food material from the host is called complete parasites. Example, Viscum, Striga, Rafflesia, Orobanchi, Cuspita. These are the examples of partial and complete parasites. Diagram is this is the diagram of parasitic roots. These are the root modifications, very very important 8 marks question. The question name is how root is variously modified to perform special functions or describe the various types of root modifications. Root modifications are 8 types.